Very few movies or no movies?
Very few are made without music.
Okay. Few movies are made without music. Do you remember any movie without music?
No. Every single one that I've seen are very dramatic and have lots of music.
Oh, so much music, dance, item number. Oh my God. Okay. Indian audiences expect full value for their money, like the each penny, the paisa vasool thing in the movie. They want dance, music, fight.
Wait a second. Not everybody knows what paisa vasool means. It means getting the most impact for your money.
Oh.
The most bang for your buck.
Okay. So, they expect full value for their money. They want songs and dances, love interest, comedy, and daredevil thrills, all mixed up in a 3-hour long extravaganza with intermission. What is intermission?
It's when you have a break in the middle.
So we can get
but popcorn. Nobody does that anymore. Everybody wants to sit there for the full 3 hours.
Can nobody go buy popcorn?
No.
Okay.
They do that beforehand.
Okay.
Or if you've watched Big Bang Theory, you also do your pre-movie, you know, bathroom break too.
Okay. So can you introduce you to Bollywood dancing? Is it classical? Kathak?
It can be. Well, it can be. There has a classical base. And then other influence as well. I think I've heard some that have Latino influence as well as Arabic influence as well. So,
yeah, the Bollywood choreographers are like mastermind. They put all dances into so many steps. Okay, Bollywood dancing is a dance which is a mix up with many more like folk dances, Latino, Arabic. It's fun, very expressive, and there's a lot of deep meaning behind the music in the films. Songs and dances express what the music means through the graceful movement of the body. So, we have now 3 Bollywood segments together representing the songs of Bollywood that showcase all different songs and styles. So, now, there'll be 3 dances together?
Well, 3 different dances, one after the other. We're just introducing all of them together. But to go back a little bit for a second here on what you said about different influences and meanings, I know that Amrita tries to teach, you know, what the inner meanings of what songs are. So it's not just, you know, you don't just listen to the music and just go with the flow. The movements that you see, the steps that you see are actually representing what the words mean. So you will actually see a physical representation of the oral, or the verbal. There we go. Of the sound.
Okay. Let's go. Okay. They want to watch.
Okay, so please welcome Harveen, Barha, Sandhya, and Arjuna.
3 dance together. We're not coming to our end.
Thank you. Thank you.
traditions which reflect the ancient Indian way of life. There is a rich and varied folk culture from villages which is often depicted symbolic of the state. Rajasthan has a global history. It is also known for many brave kings, their deeds, and their interest in art and architecture. Its name means land of the Rajas, or kings. It is also called Rajputana, the country of the Rajputs, whose codes of chivalry shape social mores, just as their often bitter and protected feuding dominated the politics. Of course, you have to get religion and politics together, right? Rajasthan, the land of kings, drenched in royal grandeur and soaked in glory into glorious history. Rajasthan is one of the most charming and captivating states of India. It has been globally famous tourist destination with lots of tourist attractions and fabulous tourist facilities. This historical state of India attracts tourists and vacationers with its rich culture, traditions, heritage, and monuments. It is also rich in flora and fauna, with some popular wildlife sanctuaries and national parks. If you've ever seen a lot of ladies, like just desert scenes in movies with ladies with colorful skirts, with their gunga top.
Why don't you tell them about Sri Devi, the gunga dance you do? The Sri Devi dance. They will only recognize the gunga dance to Sri Devi, right?
Oh yeah, that's true. I think you know it better than I do. You're the one who referenced it.
Can you ask the audience first?
Do any of you know what she's talking about? Okay.
There we go. Ask the song.
Do you know this song?
See?
There you go. See? Our audience is smart.
Yeah.
They're
so
smart.
They know Gumar through her only. Yeah, this again Bollywood, right?
It is Bollywood, but it's regional, which I love.
Okay.
Anyway, so this song.
But now you're going to watch the real Guma dance, in this real Rajasthan. We are taking you to the land of Rajasthan with the awesome dance.
So we have Rangila Maro Dolna, and this dance will be showcased by two lovely ladies, Rekha and Alzina.
Give them a big round of applause.
Yeah.
awesome. Oh, I wanted to dance with them like I was dancing in the backstage. So any of you are dancing with them, that's so musical. Oh my. So,
I at least heard some clapping. I was happy for that.
I was really dancing there.
I was too, to be honest.
Okay.
Just because I didn't know if you saw that.
I think they will be sitting and dancing, but everybody's leg might be. They're having the beats of their legs, might be.
Okay.
Our next number is Manamohini. And again, we are taking you to the land of Gujarat. From Rajasthan to Gujarat, what a big jump. Okay. Gujarat is influenced with the enculturation, a culture shared with members of the society and passed on from one generation to the next. Enculturation has unified people with common sense, experience, and influence that leads to knowledge and appreciation of cultural traditions and lifestyles. The aspect of joining hands to greet and bow down comes through age influences as offering reverence. Social systems of learning, religious practices, and forms of artistic expressions have laid way to more balanced lifestyles in Gujarat. People of Gujarat are found to be sharing cultural traits and patterns with other regions and also extend beyond national boundaries towards international culture. The music and dance behind the rich tradition with its folk music and dance. The Garba dance is the spiritual expression of Gujarat and the spirit of festivity of the traditional festival reaches worldwide. Music and folk dances have evolved since ancient times and continues to lure people to its rich tradition even today as it retains its original form or even blend to modern forms. Folk songs, classical music, and array of distinctive classical ragas have exemplary features with distinctive music variations. Gujarat is known to have produced its own folk instrument beside the vast contribution to classical and folk music. Also, modern culture of pop thrives its existence with the youth catching faster in Western and the other music form pertaining to other countries. So,
this must be asking, how many people in our audience are Gujarati? They have lived at least one Garba in their life.
Yes?
No?
Yes.
Okay, that was kind of not so loud. More noise. How many people have been in Garba? That's more noise. Good. So now we know that people are familiar with Garba, whether they're Gujarati or not.
Okay, now let's put your hand together for Mita Gupta, Mita Mathes, and Krishna Bharata. Awesome. Garba performance for Manamohini.
Yeah.
Dancing backstage. That was an awesome job, girls. Now, we had two back-to-back dances with a lot of color, a lot of movement, and so popping. So we need to show the dancers some appreciation. They love, everybody who's on stage loves hearing applause. It shows them that you appreciate what they're doing up here. Now, we've all seen many actors try to do a comeback, some to success, some to fail. This next number actually is, I don't know what to classify it. Anything this lady does is going to be successful anyway. And of course, I'm talking about none other than the marvelous Madhuri. So, of course, no Bollywood actress's repertoire is complete without dancing with lots of jhatkas and lepkas. Of course, as I said, the only person that comes to mind with all of this is Madhuri. Madhuri often is referred to as the Duck Duck Girl, which she is famous for that song, Duck Duck Karne Laga. Her grace and her rhythm often match her beauty and her passion for dance. Of course, there are a couple of audience members that I know of personally who have eyes for nobody else. I know a couple of other people who, if you show them any actress, they'll automatically say that's Shilpa Shetty, regardless of who it is. You can show them a picture of Vidya Balan, you can show them Priyanka Chopra, you can show them anybody. Automatically Shilpa Shetty. Somebody else I know, who shall remain nameless, inside jokes, has eyes only for Madhuri, like I said. It's anything, Madhuri this, Madhuri that. Oh, she can do this, only her, she can do it. So, you know, who knows? Out of all the young ladies that we have on, young and not so young ladies that we have on the stage today, who knows, we might actually have a Madhuri Diksha, the Munster. What are the chances? What do you folks think are the chances of that? I think more of you think that there is a Madhuri amongst them. I need more noise for that. Good. So, put your hands together for Lina, Vanchita, Ishu, Anushka, and Sanya.